So we are not now going to create a constructor. We are going to create a class which contains constructors. Okay. So let me name this class as X. And X contains some data members. Suppose int A comma B. Okay. And by default, the members of a class are private. So I have not written any access specifier at the beginning. If you want to make things more clear, then you can write the keyword private also. Okay. So now the things are more clear. And in the public section, we will create a constructor. As you know, the constructor is same as the name of the class. So the name of the class is X. The name of this constructor is also X. And inside this constructor, let me write a statement. Constructor called. Okay. In order to verify that constructor is actually called, we write this statement. And after the class, we have to end it with a semicolon. Okay. Now inside the main function, let us create a variable of class X, that is an object of class X, and return 0. Okay, let us try to run this. So as I told you that whenever you are executing this statement, the constructor is called automatically. Okay, let us verify whether the constructor is called or not. So constructor is called. Okay. So it means that you have not placed any call to X here. Still, this is being called. This block of statements is being executed. It means it has been verified that constructor is called. So when a constructor is called, when you are executing this statement, that is when you are creating an object of class X. Okay. Now, can we have another constructor? Can we have multiple constructors? Yes, we can have. So, suppose this is int x, comma int y. Okay. So, here this constructor is having some parameters. That is why this is called the parameterized constructor. And these parameters receive the values which we are passing. Let us see how. Let me complete it first and then I will explain. So what are we doing here? Let me create an object of class X and let me name it X1. Okay. So if I just write X1, then we have two constructors. Which one will be called? The constructor which matches with this object creation. Okay, so let us run this first. So constructor called is printed two times. It means this constructor is being called. Okay. Now let me change this. Let me write 10 comma 20 here. Now what is happening? Now we are calling this constructor. How I knew it? Because we are passing two values, 10 comma 20, inside the parenthesis when we are creating the object x1. Okay, so it means when x1 is created, then with the creation of this object you are passing two values. So the constructor which receives two values will be executed. So this is the constructor which is receiving two values. So 10 will be copied to formal parameter X and 20 will be copied to formal parameter Y. okay, and A will be x will be used to initialize the data member A, and y will be used to initialize the data member B. Okay, so let us verify it. Let me print another statement here. Cout parameterized constructor call. Okay, let's run it. There is a problem. Oh, I missed the semicolon. Now let's run it. So parameterized constructor call. Okay, so what are we doing here? We are actually doing the constructor overloading. This is called constructor overloading. Overloading means you are using the same name. The name is X, but it has different set of parameters. This X has no parameters and this X has got two parameters. Okay, so the same function or the same constructor has two different forms. This is called constructor overloading. Okay, and when you are calling X, when you are calling the constructor, how are you calling the constructor? Constructor is called automatically when you are creating the object. So the proper match will happen here, and the constructor, matching constructor, will be called automatically by the compiler. Okay, and let us check now whether the values of A and B are initialized actually or not. Okay, so let us write another function, void display. Okay, and let me write cout A equal to A cout B equal to B. Okay, and let us place a call to display here, display. Okay, so constructor call, this non-parameterized constructor is called when we are creating the first object X, and the parameterized constructor is called when we are creating the second object X1, and X1 is passing the values 10 and 20 here. So A will be initialized to 10, B will be initialized to 20. As we can see here in the output, how are we able to see this? By placing a call to display function. Display function is also a member function. Because this is a member function, it is able to access the private data members A and B. Okay, so now let us have another constructor. The constructor which takes only a single parameter. Okay, so can we create this constructor? As many constructors as we want? Yes, we can overload as many constructors as we want. The only requirement is that the parameter lists should be different. Okay, so one constructor should not be the exact copy of another. Okay, you cannot have another X with two parameters, int X, int Y. Okay, so the return type, the number or the data type of these parameters should be different in all the overloaded constructors. Okay, so here we had no parameter, here we had two ints, and here we are having one int. So each one of this parameter list of each one of these constructors is different. Okay, so we are able to have these many overloaded constructors. And let me display a message here also. Single parameter constructor call. Okay. Okay. And let me create another object. X2. And Now we are passing a single value when we are creating this object x2. So the proper matching will happen and this constructor will be called out of the three constructors we created here. Okay. Let me also check whether we are able to initialize the values x.display. Okay. So when we created first object, the no parameter constructor is called, then parameterized constructor is called when we are creating x1. When we are creating x2, the single parameter constructor is called. Okay. And this is not the only way to initialize x2. We can also write x2 equal to 100. Okay. So the output is same. But this happens only in case of a single parameter, when you are passing only single value. But when you are passing multiple values, then this assignment operator and then values, this syntax will not work. Okay.